Look, up in the air, it's a bird, it's a plane. No, it's a bird. Hey there, Flappy Birds. Jules here for DNews. You've probably seen birds migrating or making short trips for feeding, and you've probably noticed that birds tend to fly in a V shape. There's usually one bird up at the front leading the way, and each successive bird lines up back and to the right or left of the bird in front of it. There are other basic shapes, such as J formations and inverted versions of J and V formations. These groups are actually types of echelon formations, meaning that they line up linearly. V formations have been used extensively, not just by birds, but by military generals. From the earliest days of war, allegedly stemming back to when the Thebans were fighting the Spartans in 4th century BC, all the way to today, the formation is used in sea battles and aerial warfare. Birds, planes, boats, and people all have similar reasons for doing this. Lining up in a V gives each member a clear line of sight ahead of them. In some cases, it can also take less energy to travel in this formation. See, when a bird flaps its wings, a vortex of air directly behind it is pushed downwards, called downwash. Then the air further back and to the sides responds by pushing up, called upwash. Any bird situated in another bird's upwash has to expend less energy to stay afloat, since they're already being pushed upwards. And a V formation situates each member back and to the side, directly in its neighbor's upwash. In 2001, researchers at the French National Center for Scientific Research put heart rate monitors on pelicans flying in V shapes, and they found that the ones farther back had slower heart rates and did not have to flap their wings as often to stay afloat. In fact, there was an 11 to 14% total energy savings for the birds. Another study from the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences also found that the flock tries to make sure that the bird up front doesn't get too tired, since it doesn't receive any benefits from the communal upwash. The leader bird actually rotates among the flock, although scientists aren't really sure if there's a hierarchy of who gets to be the leader. Of course, all this mess could be avoided if we just taught birds how to order plane tickets. One bird, the Arctic tern, flies roughly 56,000 miles round trip and is even able to sleep while in flight. But how does the tern and plenty of other birds pull off the ability to sleep in midair? Find out in this video. And do you have any other animal questions for us? Ask us in the comments, don't forget to subscribe, and come back here for more DNews every day.